हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, तो आज हम आपको मिलवा रहे हैं प्रद्युम्न सिंह से। तो इसने अपना नाम सार्थक कर लिया है, इसके नाम के आगे सिंह जो लगा हुआ है, आज इसने वो सार्थक करके दिखाया है। ये हमारे इम्पिटस का स्टूडेंट है और आज ही एसएसबी इसने क्लियर किया। और मेरी तरफ से और हमारे पूरे इम्पिटस परिवार की तरफ से इसको आज इस सिलेक्शन पर बहुत बहुत बधाई और आगे के लिए शुभकामनाएँ।
प्रद्युम्न, सबसे पहले तो आपको बहुत बहुत बधाई। और मैं प्रद्युम्न के बारे में कुछ कहना चाहूँगा, ये राजस्थान जोधपुर से है और अभी अभी एसएसबी कंप्लीट क्लियर किया है। और ये अपने बैच का एक इकलौता बच्चा है जो कि रिकमेंड हुआ है। फाइनल आर्मी ही इसका ड्रीम था और आर्मी ही पहली चॉइस थी और फाइनली सिलेक्ट हुआ। जब ये भोपाल आया था तो इसने मुझे एक ही बात बोली थी कि सर मेरा लास्ट अटेम्प्ट है। तो मैंने बोला था कि लास्ट अटेम्प्ट नहीं, ये मान के चलो कि ये फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट है और यही लास्ट अटेम्प्ट है। पूरे 5-6 महीने सिंसियरली पढ़ाई की, उसके सामने ये रिजल्ट है। और मैं हमेशा मानता हूँ कि एनडीए में एसएसबी के 5 दिन कुछ नहीं होता है, आपकी लाइफ स्टाइल क्या है उस पर डिपेंड करता है। तो प्रद्युम्न से हम बहुत सारी बातें करेंगे, बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस पूछेंगे जिससे आपको आगे काफ़ी ज़्यादा क्लियरिटी हो। आप जब प्रिपरेशन करेंगे तो क्या क्या मिस्टेक करते हैं वो मिस्टेक दूर कर सको। पर सबसे पहले मैं चाहूँगा हम केक काटें और एक सेलिब्रेशन बनाएं, क्योंकि एसएसबी रिकमेंड होना क्या मायने रखता है ये आप सभी लोग अच्छे से जानते हैं। तो पहले हम केक काटते हैं। प्रद्युम्न, एक बार फिर से बहुत बहुत बधाई। और मैं चाहूंगा कि आप जो बच्चे बैठे हुए हैं इनको बताएं, क्योंकि एनडीए ड्रीम तो बहुत लोगों का होता है, लोग देते भी हैं, पर जो इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है नंबर वन होता है कि रिटर्न टेस्ट निकालना। बिना रिटर्न के हम एसएसबी नहीं जा सकते। कई लोग ये भी मिसकंसेप्शन पालते हैं कि हम पहले एसएसबी की तैयारी कर लें फिर रिटर्न, वो भी एक राइट ट्रैक नहीं है। दूसरा, एसएसबी में रिजेक्शन रेट बहुत हाई होता है। तो मैं हमेशा एक बात बोलता हूँ कि हमें बहुत डिसिप्लिन डे वन से होना चाहिए अगर हम डिफेंस में जाने का सोचते हैं। तो क्योंकि आपका लास्ट अटेम्प्ट था, इतना प्रेशर था, उसके बाद भी एक अच्छा परफॉर्म किया और मुझे पूरा बिलीव भी था आपको। मैं हमेशा बोलता भी था कि रिटर्न भी निकलेगा, एसएसबी भी निकलेगा, और वो कर दिखाया आपने। तो अपने जूनियर्स को आप क्या बताना चाहोगे? बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन हैं, मैं सारे डिस्कस करूंगा और ये बच्चे भी चाहेंगे आपसे कुछ क्वेश्चन पूछना। पहले आप अपना एक्सपीरियंस शेयर करिए बच्चों के साथ, फिर जो आपके डाउट्स हों वो आप पूछ सकते हो।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ प्रद्युम्न सिंह, आई एम फ्रॉम जोधपुर राजस्थान। वेल, लाइक सर सेड दैट ड्रीम ऑफ गेटिंग इनटू एनडीए इज वाज माइन आल्सो। इट वाज माय ड्रीम फ्रॉम क्लास 8 एंड 9th, एंड इट वाज माय ड्रीम आफ्टर सब्सिक्वेंटली क्लास 12th। आई गेव रिटन 3 times, बट आई फेल्ड इन, आई कुडंट मेक इट थ्रू इन द 3 attempts। देन इन द 4th attempt, I think that it was my one of the best decisions to get train here to Bhopal and come to IMPETUS Gurukul, and finally I made it in the 4th attempt. It was my final attempt also, and after the which my SSB was there. I was given well, friends, I would like to also mention that Bhopal has been lucky for me, sir. First, the written was also there, and the SSB, by God grace, was also here at the SSC Center, Bhopal. I got the 21 SSB, and again, I cleared the SSB, got recommended on the 1st of September subsequently. Friends, I would like to mention that, my dream was to get into the NDA. After class 12th, I gave the second my paper of NDA, that is 2018 first. I couldn't make it through, and then I was a little bit disappointed. Then I prepared hard, worked hard. I felt that I can make it through in the second attempt, which was of 2018 second. I prepared again with new motivation, but again something happened and I couldn't make it through. Then for the third attempt, I gave my all in. Friends, I would also like to suggest you that you make the same enthusiasm which you give for the first attempt, and don't feel like it's my first or a last attempt. Always give the paper or anything which comes in your life, any challenge in your life, with full energy, full zeal that you can do, and you'll do the best. Like then I took a train here. Well, I asked my parents. My parents told me that at least took a college. I took a drop. I didn't join a college. My father asked me to get into an engineering college, and but I told him that in engineering there will be 4 years. I'll give to the college for BTech. I told him that from these 4 years, give me 1 year to prepare for NDA, and the 3 years I will devote to NDA, and I'll get through. And he was convinced. I was sent here. I came by my own. I prepared hard for 4 months directly, and I made it through. Well, for the written part, you all know that it's basically divided into maths then GAT. I was not able to clear the maths, so my preference was of maths. People might feel that they are lacking in GAT, so they can work hard in that. So for maths, my suggestion would be follow sir, because I think there is no better teacher that in my life for maths. If you'll follow him, if you'll follow his methods, his tricks in between, you'll make it through. It will be a cup of tea for you in maths. And for GAT, I feel like the GAT is divided into two parts again. One is of English and one is of GS. For English, I would like to also mention that English is very important for getting through the written. Why? Because after maths, maths is of 300 marks. English is 200, then the science and other sections is divided subsequently. But if you focus on English, like you have to practice more. People feel like they are from the English background, they'll make it through in the English part. But when they attempt the paper, they feel like it's pure grammar. You are not speaking pure grammar when you study in your schools. You have to practice grammar more and more. You'll feel like the questions you aren't able to solve, basically the questions. So I felt like I had to concentrate on English also. So my second subject that I took was English. Now coming to the third subject was science. I was also from the science background, but I didn't feel that I was brilliant in it. I felt like that I had an edge above others, commerce and arts students. But I continued to work hard. People, that is one point that students, they do what? They don't prepare well for science section. Ultimately, they feel like it will be of no use to prepare, to devote much time. Instead, they prefer giving time to history, geography and other. I'm not telling that you should give more time to science and stop reading those history books or geography books. But what I, from my experience, I can tell you this. Well, thinking of science as a subject is one thing, and when you get these questions in your exams, we have MCQs, four options to choose from. You'll feel like A is also correct, B is also correct, C is also correct, or all aren't correct. This may happen to even PCM students. So I'll suggest that focus on your core subjects that you had in your school, and subsequently devote more time of your day. 24 hours we have, devote more time to studies, and you'll be able to give even to history and geography and pol science also. So every student has a different set of mind. They prepare differently. Some are good and extraordinary in maths, but they lack in GAT. Some are brilliant in GAT, they lack in maths. So I was like my example, I did my best in maths and I was able to clear it. Thanks sir.
Pradyumn, jaise abhi aapne bataya, sabse important baat jo isne boli aapne dhyan se suni hogi, main aap sabko bolna chahunga, attempt kaun sa ye count hi nahi karna chahiye, na to NDA ke return mein na SSB mein. जब आप दे रहे हो, आप ये मान के चलो कि पहला और आखिरी अटेम्प्ट दे रहे हो, अपना पूरा फोकस 100% देना पड़ता है, और वो इसने दिया और आपके सामने खड़ा है. पूरे बैच में अकेला बच्चा है जो सिलेक्ट हुआ, और मैं चाहूँगा कि अब आप इनके साथ, इनके डाउट्स के पहले अपने SSB के भी एक्सपीरियंस शेयर करिए, बच्चे बहुत दूर दूर से आए हुए थे, क्या क्या मिस्टेक्स करते हैं और क्या क्या चीज़ें आपने ध्यान रखी जिससे आप फाइनली रिकमेंड हो पाए, फिर आप लोग अपने जो जो डाउट्स हैं वो पूछें।
सो फ्रेंड्स, SSB इज बेसिकली द इज ऑफ 5 days। डे 1 इज द स्क्रीनिंग टेस्ट ऑफ OIR एंड PP and DT। आफ्टर विच द पीपल हु क्लियर द स्टेज 1 आर क्वालिफाइड फॉर स्टेज 2। फ्रेंड्स, माई SSB वॉज ऑन 28th, दैट इज स्क्रीनिंग वॉज ऑन 28th, एंड 38 पीपल रिपोर्टेड, of which 22 were able to make it to the stage 2. Then the second day is of psychology. In psychology there are various tests which are TAT, thematic perception tests, in which 12 slides are given in front of you, 12 pictures, and the last one is blank, and you have to write a simple story. Friends, by simple story I literally mean that the story is simple. What students generally do is they go to the they try to inculcate unnecessary the so called OLQs that are taught in various coaching academies or various other people that are previously recommended. So I would suggest you that don't do that. Be basic to the picture that is shown. If you are shown a landscape, build a story upon that. Don't show that there is a fire, there is a flood coming. Stick to the picture basically. Be that your let it be your theme. Then the second test is of WAT, that is words association test. There are a set of 60 words shown to you and you have to give your first reaction. Every word is on the screen for 15 seconds, and the test gets over after 15 minutes. Friends, for this test, I did a lot of practice, and it can be improved by a lot of practice. Basically, psychology is a test of your, as the name suggests, psychology. But what people have a misconception is, psychology can be changed within some days. My friends, it cannot. I feel like psychology is of daily basis. What you do in your routine, what you perform in your daily life matters the most. So I feel like inculcate those officers like qualities or which students take more seriously into your daily routine. Like sir says that within the first day when you fill the form of UPSC, or even before when you think to prepare for NDA, feel like that you'll be an officer someday, and inculcate that in your daily routine. Analyze that what you are doing in your routine. Analyze that what wrong did you do, and what will you'll improve the next day. Basically, this is the test of psychology. It's the first reaction that should come to you, and the psychologist is a very experienced one. He'll assess every single word of you within. He has such an experience that it won't take a matter of time for him to assess you very easily. Then after the WAT, there is another test, that is SRTs, which is situation reaction test, in which again 60 set of situations are given in front of you and you have to write the solution for it. Friends, there is a misconception again that you need to attempt least or more. That isn't the thing. Basically, it's the test of psychology. It's the person they are assessing, who's going to be the future officer. They can't risk it. There may be a situation in which there is a snake in front of you. What will be your reaction? People tend to give the reaction such as they'll catch the snake by his head and throw it away, or some or the other. My reaction was simple, that I wrote actually in the SSB, that I took a towel and threw it on the snake and silently went out of the room and informed the concerned authority. These simple, they are expecting that we are NDA guys, we are 12th pass. They're expecting these reactions that we are having at our age. We can't give the reaction of the age of 25 or 35 or even more. So they are expecting the reactions of our age, 18, maybe 19, 20. So that's the thing in SRTs. Then is the last test of psychology, which is SD, self-description, in which you have to give the give opinions of your parents, teachers, mine was classmates, and your self-opinion. For this, you can practice it at home. It's very easy. You are given 15 minutes for it, and you may ask your parents what they think about you, what your classmates think about you, what your teachers think about you, and the most important, what you self think about you. That's very important. Everyone gives their strengths. They boast about their strength. I would like to mention that you have to. You should also give a few areas of improvements that you can improve in future and you would like to improve. Then the psychology tests are over, then there are GTO tests. The GTO tests, the full form is group tests. They are performed in a group. Friends, in the group tests, what the candidates generally do is, the name is also already the group test. You have to perform as a group. But what they do is, candidates perform it as a take it as an individual. They tend to perform that they won't get marks, whether it is GD, whether it is you're performing with the Fatta Balli and Rassi. So friends, be active with the group. You while preparing for the written, you may also feel like interact with the group, be friendly with them, cooperation is very important thing. With your naturality comes from the day one when you think to appear for the NDA exam. That's the most important and point which I feel. GTO has several series of tests. Mine were the first day they completed 6 tests and all went brilliantly well by my side. I gave my 100% in every test possible, and in the next test there was command task, there were lecturate, and there were it was one more test. So friends, in the GTO tests, it is basically your group cooperation, as well as it is systematically built so to test your knowledge, to bring the OLQs out of you. Then there are several assessors who are looking for these possibilities of a officer in future, a candidate who is trainable, a candidate who can command, a candidate who can perform in a group, and a candidate who can perform even individual if he doesn't have any men around. They want to check that how can he perform. So GTO test is very scientifically built to assess the candidates. Then meanwhile, within these 3 days, you'll have your interview, personal interview. One senior officer will take your interview and it will last for 30 to 45 minutes. And prior to this interview, you will be given a form to fill, which is a personal information questionnaire, a PIQ form, in which you will give your details, family background, educational qualifications, and you will give your hobbies and interests and all those stuffs. Friends, focus on these things. Like you guys are preparing for written exam, try to inculcate those things which you'll write in your PIQ when you'll appear for your SSB in future. What can you mention that you're a probable candidate of NDA in the future, you're probable cadet of the National Defence Academy in the future. Try to inculcate from right on. I'd also tried the same. This is the thing. Interview lasts for, like I said, 30 to 45 minutes. He'll, while talking to you, he'll assess from your head to toe while talking to you. He's the only person who has this much interaction within the 5 days of SSBs. Now, my interview went pretty well. He was asking basically from every IO, that is interviewing officer asked from the PIQ, because no other information is there besides the PIQ, and even the general knowledge questions and the reactions. Like I was questioned, when I mentioned that I play football, he asked me that suppose your principal has asked you to to arrange a race in the football field. What will be the longest possible race course that you will take without repeating any step? So I told him that I'll take the diagonal, and then he asked me what will be the distance, and I answered it immediately. So he was good. He moved on to my other questions. So be quick, be confident. Confidence is the key, basically, in the SSB, the 5 days procedure, whether it is you're interacting with the group, you're performing the individual obstacles, you're performing individually. Everywhere, confidence is the key. Now, friends, you'll ask that how will I build my confidence? How will I be confident enough in life? Friends, one of the most important part that plays in boosting the confidence is knowledge. Knowledge plays an important role, because when you are knowledgeable, you are confident enough to speak. You're confident enough to express. So try to build your knowledge. Knowledge is not like bookish knowledge. It is not like that. Everyday knowledge about life, knowledge about when you are asked to, like I said, even you will be given any situation, any question can be asked. Your quick responses show your knowledge. So this is the SSB procedure of 4 days. Then the fifth day is your conference, in which all the officers, including the president, are sitting in front of you, and they ask nominal questions, the stay. And in my conference, he asked me what I felt new in this environment. I answered him immediately. I answered him that it was my first experience in a military environment. I liked the discipline. I learned their discipline. All right. Then my interviewing officer was there also. He asked me that what did you do to reach this stage? I told him there also, from the last 1 year I've been trying, and I am here. He moved on. Then he asked me about my stay and food and all. Then the SSB procedure is done, after which you are given time. Then after your lunch, or maybe before your lunch, there are results. In my result, I feel like proud to say that I was the only one. My chest number was 20. The Lieutenant Colonel sir stood before us and called my name, chest number 20. I rose up proudly with my chest out, and went away with the new chest number with a plus sign. Thank you.
देखो अभी इसने जैसा एसएसबी का एक्सपीरियंस शेयर किया, मैं आपसे हमेशा एक बात बोलता हूँ, वही बात बोली कि कॉन्फिडेंस और डिसिप्लिन लाइफ में बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। और कितनी अच्छी बात बोली, कॉन्फिडेंस हमेशा नॉलेज से आता है। कोई आपसे बोले कि कॉन्फिडेंस के साथ ये काम करो, आप कर नहीं सकते जब तक कि आपके अंदर नॉलेज नहीं। और मैं हमेशा इसका क्या एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ कि अगर आपको तैरना नहीं आता और मैं बोलूँ कूद जाओ कॉन्फिडेंस के साथ, तो क्या कूद सकते हो पानी में? कूद भी गए तो बचना मुश्किल है। अगर तैरना अच्छे से आता और फिर मैं बोलूं कॉन्फिडेंस के साथ कूद जाओ, तो पक्की बात है कि आप अच्छे से जीत के निकलोगे। वही काम इसने किया। तो नॉलेज बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ है, और जितनी स्ट्रांग नॉलेज होगी उसका उतना ही अच्छा रिजल्ट मिलेगा, और वो आपके सामने। तो जब से आपके मन में अगर ये ख्याल आ जाए कि डिफेंस में जाना है, तो हर दिन आपकी लाइफ का डिफेंस जैसा होना चाहिए, और वैसी लाइफ स्टाइल जीना चालू करो, वैसे ही डिसिप्लिन में जीना चालू करो। एक एक सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी आपकी क्या है पता होना चाहिए। अगर रोड पे एक्सीडेंट हुआ तो आपका थॉट क्या आता है, किसी दुर्घटना को देख के आप क्या सोचते हो, कोई लोग फंसे हुए तो उनको देख के क्या सोचते हो। 5 दिन आर्टिफिशियल बन के नहीं चल सकता, ये जो बात इसने बोली। जो पर्सन ऑनेस्ट होता है वही फाइनली सिलेक्ट होता है। तो आप सबको मैं यही मैसेज देना चाहूँगा कि आप बिल्कुल ईमानदारी से ऑनेस्ट हो जाएं और सोच लें कि डिफेंस में जाना है, तो वो लाइफ जो वो जीने वाले हैं वो आपके अंदर आज से आना चाहिए। अब मैं चाहूँगा कि आपके जो जो डाउट्स हैं वो आप पूछें, और अपने डाउट भी दूर करें, और बिल्कुल फोकस होकर पढ़ाई करें।
जनरली जब हम लोग एसएसबी वगैरह की प्रिपरेशन शुरू करवाते हैं, तो होता क्या है कि बच्चों को जब ये बताया जाता है कि सर्विस सिलेक्शन बोर्ड इन 15 ऑफिसर लाइक क्वालिटीज़ को आप में तलाश रहा है, तो इंस्पाइट ऑफ इनकल्केटिंग दोज क्वालिटीज़, बच्चे क्या करते हैं फिर प्रिटेंड करना शुरू कर देते हैं, उस तरीके से एक्ट करने लगते हैं। सो इनको एडवाइस करें, इनको बताएं कि भाई ये एक्टिंग कितनी डिजास्ट्रस हो सकती है एसएसबी में, एंड क्या तरीका है, क्या प्रोसीजर्स आपको लगाने चाहिए अपनी नॉर्मल डे टू डे लाइफ में, ताकि ये क्वालिटीज आप अपने अंदर इनकलकेट करें, ताकि जब आप एसएसबी के सामने जाएं तो आपको शो ना करना पड़े कि मेरे में ऑफिसर लाइक क्वालिटीज हैं, वो अपने आप रिफ्लेक्ट हों आपके बिहेवियर से.
Yes, sir. So answering this question, yes, in the SSB also I felt like people were focusing on OLQs. They, friends, I would like to mention that every person, every individual has the OLQs in him. In SSB, you've got to show the OLQs. But like sir said, that people tend to show their OLQs consciously. SSB is all about showing your OLQs unconsciously, in my opinion. For the OLQs, there are 15 set of OLQs that everyone reads. They're in books, they're in every coaching academy. What I feel is these 15 OLQs, which are in everyone, can't be inculcated within a period of 14 to 15 days. It is a continuous life process. You have to carry it on from the day one to the day end of your life. Like sir said, they tend to show these OLQs. Mine group was also like this. You have to be smart in that, I feel like. While writing certain psychology tests, you have got to be smart, not over smart. SSB, in SSB, or a probable officer or cadet candidate, what they are seeing is the candidate, the level shouldn't be too much or shouldn't be too low. There is a certain limit in which a candidate should fall, and they take it from there. Talking about OLQs, OLQs is in everyone. You have to practice it daily. It is a daily routine. While you are you all are preparing for NDA written, OLQ which is ready, which I feel which isn't mentioned, which should be mentioned, is dedication, which was my core strength. I was dedicated enough from right till the beginning to the end. Dedication brings a lot of OLQs also, sincerity, it brings continuity in your written also, it helps in the future also. While you are preparing for written, what you can do is, every person is its own assessor. Who can judge you or assess you better than yourself? No one. So try to try to assess yourselves that what I did in the day. Sit, like Sharad sir says, sit in the bed just before you are sleeping. Try to assess the whole day, what you did wrong, what you did right, and try to improve that the shortcomings the day before, and try to improve it in the future. It will help. It will definitely help. You are your own assessors. Like you are preparing for written, where I, you, if your marks is low, you will be knowing why I am lacking. Why I am not getting the required marks. Why I am, you don't have the satisfaction yourself when you don't have marks. Why? People nowadays tend to put that thing aside. The assessment of self, that is self-assessment, is very important. What I feel people today lacks, because what they do is they don't self-assess. They look on to others, what the other person is doing or performing. The competition is with no one, particularly in the defense forces. It's with your own self. In the SSB also, and while I was here at the IMPETUS, I was a part of it. And whenever the list came, there's a list after every tests. And when I used to find my name at the bottom line, I used to feel like that this won't do well. Then I used to prepare hard, and I used to make sure that when I get the 10th rank, I'll make sure it won't be 10th again. It will be 9th or further above. This is the some things that you should do in your daily life while preparing, like you guys are preparing for NDA. You have to be sincere. You have to be dedicated. You've got your exam on the 17th of November. You have to prepare well. You are your own assessor. You have to do it like that.
एक क्वेश्चन और जो जनरली मतलब काफ़ी सारे कैंडिडेट जो एसएसबी की तैयारी कर रहे हैं उनकी तरफ से मतलब ये उठाया जाता है कि जैसे ग्राउंड पे आपके जीटीओ के प्रोग्रेसिव ग्रुप टास्क से जब अपने टास्क शुरू होते हैं करना तो काफ़ी सारे लोग अब एसएसबी की स्पेसिफिक कोचिंग ज्वाइन करते हैं 14 दिनों के लिए या 21 दिनों के लिए एंड उसमें दे जस्ट लर्न सम सॉर्ट ऑफ ट्रिक्स कि भाई आपने पट्टा इस तरह से लगा देना है ऐसे कर देना है एंड ऑल दैट एंड जनरली ये देखा गया कि प्रोग्रेसिव ग्रुप टास्क का जो थर्ड टास्क आता है तब तक आते आते ऑल द ट्रिक्स फेल एंड देन कैंडिडेट्स आर जस्ट ट्राइंग टू use all those tricks and techniques that are not applicable yes. and that is something that that type of behavior is something that generally just diminishes their chances of selection. So I'd like to know from you that what should be the approach while we are doing all these tasks on the ground and besides this just share your experience as well that what was the approach by the third task of progressive group task and obviously in command task as well how you approached them what was the bent of mind and in what way you just went through them
yes sir definitely so in PGT you are given certain structures and you're given certain helping materials which is fatta balli and rassi or maybe more from the GTOs like sir said the candidates go to the coachings and learn the specific methods of tying knots or they confuse and restrict them ability to think with that they restrict themselves to think there only what I feel is the tests are designed such to assess candidates reasoning ability or organizing ability within a group as how a candidate will move from point A to point B with having certain challenges and restrictions. So friends, like the coached candidates are such which have a mask while appearing for SSB. They tend to have another shade of personality which they actually don't and they show the mask not the inner self. Friends, this is the SSRs are very very experienced. There are batches and batches coming in front of them and there are candidates in front of them and it's their regular task. So within seconds they'll assess and they'll give their assessment about that. So I feel like for these tasks, one has to be mentally prepared. Preparing mentally, what in my task was that my basic thinking was keeping aside what I have learned from various other platforms, keeping aside that, and with a new mindset, I attempted these tasks. And my main aim was to get myself and my group to the next stage. That is, in PGT there are basically four. The level generally increases within after each level, and in the command task also, my main aim was to move from the platform which I was standing on, complete the task within the time. So for this, even if you attempt, apply or go to a coaching, it doesn't matter. Your personality basically won't change. You'll learn tying knots, or you'll learn keeping how to tackle the structures in the coaching. But there in the SSB, it is completely new, and your inner self will come. And the candidates who are able to control themselves and think wisely in front of others with the constraint of time usually get through. And the people who restrict themselves after the coaching. Doesn't go through. That's all.
Which topics you have got in your GD and lecturate?
All right. For the GD, There are two GTs basically in the SSB. The first topic, there is a choice given by the GTO to us. First choice was what is the rising reasons, what is the core reason out of the three given for the rising extreme droughts and extreme floods in the world and in India. One was climate change, second was deforestation, and third was increasing in infrastructure. The second topic that we had to choose from was overpopulation. We chose the former one, and the second GT that is conducted, the GTO gives the topic by himself. Our topic was with the technological time, the increase in video gaming, and what it affects the youth. The most. The first one was aggressiveness, second was it lowers the social adaptability of any individual, and the third one was academics, their lower academics. These are the three topics. In the GTs, I feel like the GTO itself instructs that out of the three, which is your which in your opinion is the most important issue. So stick to the one topic. Speak frankly. In our GD, it was a brilliant one. Each one of us was able to speak, give his point of view, and we were well. What I felt is, by my knowledge, by my habits of reading and getting through GK, I was able to give the points, valid points, which is very important. The SSS is looking his ability to influence groups and also the knowledge that he possesses. So that's very important for GDs.
First of all, congratulations for your recommendation.
You.
My question is, how you manage study hours in preparing while written?
All right. Friends, I was, like I mentioned before, that I was not able to clear the maths part. So everyone has the period of 24 hours in a day. Every individual has a different set of mind. He has to approach the subjects differently. So mine was basically focused on maths. Then I said English, then science, and then the remaining history, geography, and pol science. So I used to give maximum, like from 100%, I would devote 75% to 80% to maths alone, because I was confident enough that I'll get good marks in GAT because of my hard work in previous attempts. So I used to devote my time in maths. I used to prepare a lot. I used to work hard on these subjects and practicing a lot, facing new questions. Similar types of questions can anybody solve. Anybody can solve it. But if you come across different set of question, you will get struck sometime. So getting new things, getting new questions from elsewhere will help you a lot. I for the time being, I used to devote at least 5 hours for maths, and then 2 hours for English, or I felt so in the day.
First of all, congratulations, Vaya. Share
you.
About the ICE medical process, sir.
Sir?
ICE medical process during the SSB medical.
All right. After the SSB, you're given, you fill certain forms, and you're given a new chest numbers and all that stuff. And from the next day onwards, they take you to the MH, in which the actual medical tests begin. Every day has a specific medical test, like the surgicals, the medicine. You've got your ultrasound and other stuffs like that. There is a report at the end of the medical tests, like the conference of the SSB. It is not like that basically, but there's a conference of medical also, in which they tell you that you're fit or unfit, and they give you, if you are unfit, they give you a temporary rejection, and you'll apply for the appeal medical board in the hospital mentioned, and you'll get there.
How we can tackle our PPDT?
PPDT?
Yeah.
All right. For PPDT, it's basically PPNDT, picture perception and discussion test. For picture perception, there is a picture shown for 15 to 30 seconds on the screen, and you've got to write a story upon that. Now, story, the picture in the PPDT is a little bit hazy or a blur if compared to TAT, thematic perception test of psychology. Now, it is purposefully made blur to it is a test of perception, and it is purposefully made blur to test that what a candidate actually perceives from the picture. If there isn't any there is a sort of fire or something like that, if you are assuming fire, or somebody can even assume another thing, there is a elephant and you assume it as a tank or something, it is like that. You have to write a picture, and after writing the picture, you are divided into groups. Then when in the group, you have to narrate the picture. The GTO, the assessors will be there in front of you, the psychology IO, psychologist, and the GTO, and he'll assess you upon the narration. The narration should be short, crisp, and confident. And after the narration, when the last candidate finishes his narration, the GTO will tell you to discuss and come upon a common theme and make a story upon that, in which you are again there is a group discussion. You give that there also things like observation powers matters, what you observed, what how you perform in a group matters, and the SSU. It is basically divided. It is the stage one test. SSB is divided into two tests, stage one and stage two. Stage one is this, and in addition to OIR, and stage two is the subsequent tests. You've got 70. What I feel is every test is designed such that OIR is 25%, again followed by 25% your story, 25% narration, 25% discussion. You SSB, like I felt from my experience, is the test of your consistency, how consistent you are, right from this beginning of attempting the written till the end of your commissioning or your retirement. You have to be consistent. What I felt like different, what the assessors, what I in my opinion felt different in me was the consistency. How consistent was I in the PPDT, then psychology, GTO and IO. I gave my 100% in all and performed to be consistent. That's all.
Congratulations for getting recommended. So there are two questions. First, that you said that you have failed three times. So I in the previous attempt when I have given a test in April, I was so sure that I will definitely clear this time, but I failed. So what keeps you motivated that this time I will not only clear the written, but I will also get recommended? So what was your source of motivation? And the second question is that sometimes a thought comes that what if that this time also I will fail. So what you have done to keep away yourself from this negative thoughts?
All right, coming to my motivation part, I gave three written attempts, and the fourth one made me clear. What kept me motivated was my hunger to get into the NDA. There should be a self motivation which plays an important role in everybody. There is the self hunger to achieve your dream, to achieve your goal in life. That is very important. That keeps you pushing from behind. There will be motivation from your friends, your teachers, your friends, but the self motivation is the thing which matters the most. That pushed me harder to work better than the past. And again, in the future, I assess myself where I lagged. I assess that what needs to be improved. And accordingly, I performed. I made the plan and performed. The second question was?
Second question was that sometimes a thought comes that what if that if this time also I fail or something?
Yeah, this thought comes to every. This can come to anyone. That what if I fail in this one? Or it can. It was also there in front of me when I was giving my final attempt. that what if that this is also gone and what will I do? I won't get into NDA. This is one thing. You have to be optimistic about that. You have to keep working upon hard. Give your 100%, do your best, and everything remains in the hands of God and your faith and your fortune, basically. So on your part, what is in your hands is your mehnat, is your hard work and your dedication that you can perform till the first you have written, and the results subsequently depends upon that. So what if, the question of what if is basically there. You have to be optimistic that even if it is the final attempt, you have to think that, all right, it doesn't matter. In the future, I'll do great endeavors. I'll appear for the defense, other defense exams, CDS, and other government exams. But there's a backup also of yours, which also comes into play. But basically, you have to take the target. What if doesn't come into play if you're dedicated enough, I feel.
इसके अलावा इस क्वेश्चन का मैं भी आंसर देना चाहूँगा जैसे ये आया था. देखो, आपने जो पूछा ना, तीन अटेम्प्ट में रिटर्न ही निकला, लास्ट अटेम्प्ट रिटर्न था. थॉट ये भी आता है कि रिटर्न निकल भी गया तो एसएसबी में तो बहुत लोग रिजेक्ट होते हैं. फर्स्ट एसएसबी तो बहुत ही लोग कम क्लियर करते हैं, इसने फर्स्ट एसएसबी ही क्लियर करी. अगर आप पढ़ाई करते समय रिजल्ट ओरिएंटेड पढ़ाई करोगे तो आपके फेल होने के परसेंटेज कई ज़्यादा हैं सक्सेसफुल होने से. तो मैं आप लोगों को क्या एक बात बोलता हूँ कि आप नॉलेज के लिए पढ़ो. रिटर्न निकलेगा कि नहीं, एसएसबी निकलेगा कि नहीं, सब छोड़ दो. अगर एक सेवा आप डिफेंस में नहीं जा पाए तो कुछ और अच्छा करने वाले हो लाइफ में, पर मेहनत करने वाले का कभी कोई नुकसान नहीं होता. दूसरी बात, डिफेंस में अगर कोई ने चाह लिया कि जाना है तो मुझे नहीं लगता कि वो नहीं जा सकता. बहुत ऑप्शंस हैं, आगे भी बहुत ऑप्शंस हैं, पर हमें ना आगे का ऑप्शन सोचना है ना पीछे का, कुछ नहीं सोचना. अभी आप सब लोग किसकी प्रिपरेशन कर रहे हो? रिटर्न की. रिटर्न पर फोकस रखो. रिटर्न निकल जाएगा, एसएसबी के लिए क्या करना, एसएसबी की देखो प्रद्युम्न ने भी बताया, मैं भी आपको हमेशा बोलता हूँ, कोई अलग से प्रिपरेशन नहीं होती, वो आपकी रियल लाइफ स्टाइल है. आप कितने ईमानदार हैं वो चीज डिपेंड करेगी आपके सिलेक्शन के लिए. ये बात दिमाग में रखो. कभी भी ये मत सोचो कि नहीं होगा तो क्या होगा. नहीं होगा या होगा ये बर्ड दिमाग से ही निकाल दोगे तो ज़्यादा अच्छा होगा. इसलिए जब ये आया था, मैंने इसको कई बार ऑफिस में जब केबिन में आता था, मैं बोलता था तुम्हारा ये फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट है मेरे लिए, तो मेरे पास अभी आया मैं तो फर्स्ट मानूंगा. जो तीन दिए भूल जाओ. जब हम पास को देखते हुए प्रेजेंट में करते हैं तो रिजल्ट अच्छा नहीं होता. मेरा एक बिल्कुल क्लियर कंसेप्ट है कि मुझे जो चाहिए वो मेरा फ्यूचर है, उसका वर्क प्रेजेंट है और उसका रिजल्ट पास्ट है. जो निकल गया उसको नहीं बदल सकते. तो आप सब लोगों को ये बोलूंगा कि आपका पहला, सेकेंड, थर्ड, फोर्थ क्या अटेम्प्ट है ये भूल जाओ. आप अपना अपना पूरा फोकस पॉजिटिव माइंड से रखो. जब आप बार में जाओगे डिफेंस वाले बच्चे, अगर आप डिफेंस में जाते हो, जरूरी थोड़ी जीत के आओ, हार भी सकते हो, जीत भी सकते हो, कुछ भी हो सकता है. सचिन तेंदुलकर कई बार जीरो पे आउट हुआ तो क्या अगले मैच में खेलने नहीं गया? सेंचुरी मारना है तो जीरो पे भी आउट होना पड़ेगा, और सेंचुरी के लिए 100 रन तक पहुंचना पड़ेगा. 99 पे भी होगा आउट तो भी काउंट नहीं होगा. फिर अगली सेंचुरी के लिए कहां से काउंटिंग होगी? जीरो. यानी पहले एक रन बनेगा, दो रन बनेंगे, फिर वो थॉट प्रोसेस अपने साथ रखो. कहीं कभी भी निगेटिव थॉट मत आने दो अपने. जिस दिन निगेटिव थॉट आएंगे कि होगा कि नहीं, बस समझ लो उस दिन से आपका डाउनफॉल चालू हो जाता है. आप अपनी पढ़ाई नॉलेज के लिए करो, कॉन्फिडेंस के साथ करो. वो कॉन्फिडेंस आपका अभी भी झलकना चाहिए, और वो अभी झलकेगा ना तो एसएसबी तक काम आने वाला. तो वो सब डर निकाल दो. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन.
So congratulations for recommendation. And I want to ask, what was your strategy in the last month before the exam and during the last week and before the exam? What was your strategy there?
All right. I followed Sharad sir. Like sir said, he planned the written part very brilliantly. Last month was dedicated to the exams. We had tests one after the other. Every alternate day we had a maths test, we had a GAT test, and I used to appear in every test possible and used to give my best. Whichever test comes before you, you prepare it according that you are, this is your final attempt. Give your best, give your 100%, and it doesn't matter you fail or pass in that. That is just the warm up. The final test, you will be prepared as such that you will be out with the flying colors. So my strategy was one prior to my exam was that I was given a series of papers, previous year papers, papers made by Sharad sir, questions. I used to devote more time. I studied what I know. This is finished. कि भाई ये हो गया है बस अभी यहाँ तक ठीक है अब इससे ज़्यादा आई यूज़ टू नॉट गो फार फ्रॉम बियॉन्ड दैट एंड द टेस्ट केम इन टू प्ले आई यूज़ टू ऑल्सो आई डिड द सेम लाइक शरद सर सेड जस्ट अ डे बिफोर द एग्ज़ाम आई डिडंट स्टडीड एट ऑल लाइक राइट बिफोर द एग्ज़ाम आई स्लेप्ट ऑल द डे गॉट आउट विद माई फ्रेंड्स हैड डिनर एंड अदर स्टफ्स एंड विद अ फ्रेश माइंड आई गेव माई एग्ज़ाम विच हेल्प्ड अ लॉट literally so follow Sharad sir you'll definitely come out with flying colors
my question is that communication skill is very important for the SSB interview and what should be the approach for communication skill for 2 months and how you prepare for SSB
all right for communication skill SSB doesn't say that you have to communicate in English or Hindi you can communicate you can be bilingual or you can prefer either language but it is preferred that English is the medium of future when you're talking to officers you have to speak in English so it is preferred well for the communication skills when you interact with your friend again or any other person Again, one thing comes into play is your knowledge. Knowledge, I'll again mention that it is doesn't restrict yourself to the books. Bookish knowledge can be learned from it can be learned by anyone, but you have to communicate as such. You have to for communication like I mentioned that knowledge is very important you when you're a knowledgeable person other person also feels like that yes I think I should interact with him I should get along with him he also feels warmth with you and that's all
congratulations
thank you
what rank you used to score in a weekly test of IMPETUS GURUKUL
all right when I first came here I was confident ki in GAT I'll be on the top always and in the maths I'll gradually come up when the first test came I think I got the 10th rank our batch was small initially 15 were there and I got the 10th rank I wasn't demotivated but I felt a little bit disappointed as I had prepared earlier and why wasn't I able to score more there are also candidates like me I didn't look on to other person's rank I looked at my digit that was 1 and 0 I prepared for the next test then I got 7 or 8 and gradually it increased so the self assessment and these things comes into play when you prepare for it so this is
as you say it is your it was your last attempt and it is also my last attempt so how can you face the written exam whenever someone is going to panic about in the written exam
well I would like to mention sir's quote that this won't be your last attempt it will be your first and the final attempt sir says that this is whenever you feel like it is the final attempt you feel like what if comes to, into your life what if you don't pass what if you don't clear this thing keep aside those things keep aside the negativity that that comes that the shadow of negativity which is haunting you that what if I don't pass in it is my final attempt give it like the with the full enthusiasm and zeal prepare it that it is not my last but final attempt prepare it like that you should have the hunger of getting through that it doesn't matter if you don't you'll have future endeavors don't feel disheartened and disappointed if you don't make it through but prepare it if you are dedicated enough
First of all, very very congratulations for your recommendation. My question is, something tell me about your GTO test in your SSB.
All right. So, GTO test is a battery of several tests in which you are divided into groups, and like the name suggests, group testing officers. The name also suggests that you have to perform in a group. The assessors assesses your behavior, your participation in a group. So for that, try to give your best whenever you are in a group. Even group may vary, the numbers may vary. Group is of 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 11. You have got a good strength in your class. Cooperate with them, motivate them to work hard, like it is in NDA written exam. Work hard. So it is basically your group cooperation, and your you doesn't pass or fail, your group does. So like there is a race called group obstacle race or snake race, in which there is a race between mine were three groups and I was the third. We had several heavyweights in our group also, and we planned accordingly. Our plan was to get those heavyweights first, and then we'll come and try. So then they also, GTO is there to assess you, that how you are you performing in the group, how you are helping your mates. That's all. GTO tests isn't about the individual. Keep this in mind. It is about the group performance. Even in the GTs, what you are contributing to the group is what matters. So I think group effectiveness, group cooperation are the key.
What was the reason that you gave in your SSB for dropping out from 12th class?
All right. So when I got into the room of interviewing officer, after my name and from place where I belong, I was questioned the same that you asked. What you did in the past, there is a PIQ form like I mentioned, in which I mentioned that I did my 12th in 2018. And he asked me from the beginning that what you completed your 12th in 2018, and from 2018 what were you doing till now. So I was this is where my honesty came into play, and I was honest enough to give the right and apt answer that, sir, I was preparing, I was dedicated, I couldn't get through the first three attempts, but I made it through my fourth attempt. I mentioned the IMPETUS coaching, mentioned Sharad sir, that he was there, he cleared my maths exam, and I'm with my hard work I cleared the maths exam. I felt like the interview officer was satisfied with my answer.
Yeah, my SSB interview is 12 September. What should we do to improve narration part?
All right. For narration, what I did is, everyone says that they perform in front of mirror. I did the same also. You're the best assessor of yourself. I used to stand in front of a single mirror, locked my room, and I used to speak my heart out. I used to speak a lot. I used to make my videos, and I used to assess myself as well. You must be having your family also to support. My family was there. I used to speak in front of my father and my sister, and that's all. My narration improved.
थैंक यू प्रद्युमन.
थैंक यू सर.
बहुत अच्छी आपने इन्फॉर्मेशन दी, और आप सबको भी इस इन्फॉर्मेशन का बेनिफिट मिलेगा. और याद रखिए, लास्ट फर्स्ट कुछ नहीं होता. आप लोगों ने अभी अभी न्यूज़ पढ़ी होगी, चंद्रयान फेल हो गया हमारा. तो क्या आप उसे फेल मानते हैं? 10 साल की मेहनत के बाद बहुत ही थोड़े से दूरी से फेल हुआ, तो क्या ये फेल हुआ? अगेन फिर से ट्राई किया जाएगा और आगे बढ़ा जाएगा. बिल्कुल, अगर आपकी सोच में पॉजिटिवनेस है ना, तो कभी भी पीछे मुड़ के नहीं देखना पड़ता. तो आप सारी चीज़ें भूल जाइए, अपना फोकस बिल्कुल मत हटाइए, अपने फोकस के साथ पढ़ाई करिए हर टेस्ट को, क्योंकि अब आपकी टेस्ट सीरीज चालू हो रही है. हर टेस्ट को बहुत सीरियसली लीजिए. और ये तो बहुत छोटे से बैच का स्टूडेंट है, स्टार्टिंग में 15 थे, बाद में 19 बच्चे हुए, उन्हीं बच्चों में से अभी 8 बच्चे सिलेक्ट हुए. अभी तो ये पहला निकला, अभी बाकी लोग SSB देने जाने वाले हैं, उनमें से भी उम्मीद है कि कुछ बच्चे और सिलेक्ट होंगे, उन सबसे भी मिलोगे आप. पर बस एक ही बात ध्यान रखिएगा कि आप अपना फोकस कभी भी डाइवर्ट ना होने दें। जहां फोकस हटता है वहीं पर हमारा रिजल्ट बिगड़ता है। हर टेस्ट में, मतलब जब 15 बच्चों की टेस्ट में अगर 10th रहेंगे तो आप समझ सकते हो कितना पीछे था मैथ्स में। डर भी मैथ्स का था, धीरे धीरे निकल गया। मैं तो हमेशा बोलता हूं आपसे, मैथ्स से डर छोड़ दो, आपको जीएटी पे फोकस करना। जब भी आया था तो इसने मुझे एक ही बार बोला था, जीएटी की चिंता नहीं मैथ्स की। मैंने कहा फिर चिंता छोड़ दो, और अभी भी बोल रहा हूं आपको, अब तो मैथ्स और जीएटी दोनों की चिंता नहीं करनी। दोनों आपका बहुत अच्छे से हो रहा है। 2.5 महीने आपको फुल लेंथ टेस्ट सीरीज मिलने वाली है, अच्छा रिजल्ट आएगा। पॉजिटिव माइंड से पढ़ो, आपको भी मैं बहुत सारी बधाई दूंगा। और अभी जीवन में बहुत आगे जाना है, ये स्टार्ट है। अब एक्चुअल में जो डिफेंस का सपना देखा अब वो चालू होगा, पहले ट्रेनिंग फिर एक्चुअल में ज्वाइनिंग, और बहुत नाम कमाओ, बहुत आगे जाओ, और ऐसे ही जूनियर्स को मोटिवेट करते रहो। थैंक यू एंड ऑल द बेस्ट। थैंक यू।